Hello guys, good morning. Magandang araw ulit sa inyo lahat. So, our topic for today is the continuation lang nung nakaraan. So, work, energy, and power. So, nung nakaraan ay ang mga diniscuss lang natin is work energy, theorem, or and also the kinetic energy kapag yung ating motion ay nasa straight line. Okay? So ngayon, i-discuss natin ay work energy when the motion of a particle or an object is in a curved path. Okay? Yan, work energy theorem for motion along a curve. So before we start, alamin muna natin kung ano yung formula, ano, kung saan ba nakuha. So, in figure A, so nakikita natin, so suppose a particle or an object moves from point 1 to point 2 and acted on by vector F. So when we say vector, yan ay pwedeng in terms of IJK or unit vector, ha? So vector F, so ibig sabihin ay nagbabari yung direction ng ating force, ano? And also varying din yung magnitude niya. Okay? So yung ang para makuha natin yung logic niyan, so during an infinitesimal displacement vector dl, so nakikita nyo, so para makuha natin yung total work within point 1 to point 2 to point 2 ay since varying yung direction niya, hindi siya straight, so meaning kailangan nating mag-integrate. So kukuha tayo ng infinitesimal displacement, so infinitesimal element, so maliit na element dun sa curved path, and then yung mag-a-act na force dun, so yung vector F natin, which is also varying, ano, and that force will contribute a work dw. So yun yung d work natin on a particle. So dun, yung dw na yan, yan yung work on the first element only, on one element only. So kung nakikita nyo sa figure, yung kulay pulang vector F na yan, and yung infinitesimal displacement d vector dl. Okay? So displacement yan, maliit na displacement, kasi yung total displacement is from here to point dito. Yun yung total displacement eh. Kaso, nagva-vary siya. So kailangan natin kumuha ng maliit na isang element na dl. Ito yung total displacement eh. Ito yung l. Yan. Pamula dyan hanggang doon. Okay? So kailangan natin kumuha ng maliit. So yung infinitesimal displacement dl. And yung mag-a-act doon is the varying force vector F also. And nagbabary yung vector F as the angle P changes. So yun yung angle P, oh. Nakikita nyo. So angle between the vector F and the vector DL. So nakita yung ating unang-unang discussion is work, kapag work ay it is the best example of scalar product, ano, or the dot product. So the dot product or the scalar product of the two vector quantities is defined on our previous topic, ano. So makakaraan na, ano. So yung f cosine dl ganyan. So dapat parallel yung ating force with respect to the another vector displacement, ano. So yan, so mamaya papaliwanag natin. So that dw is equals to, kasi ang work natin is force times displacement, di ba? So vector F, so ang displacement, so vector F, ibig sabihin hindi pa ito mismo yan, hindi pa ito mismo, hindi pa yung vector F na yan, yung direction, hindi pa yan, kundi yung parallel doon saan? Doon sa vector displacement dl. So ano yung parallel niya? Ito yung dl natin. So ito yung maliit na displacement, vector dl. And yung force natin ito, vector F. And nagbabari siya with respect to our angle P. So yung ating work dyan, ang work na magaganap dyan is yung ating DW. So yung DW, yan yung work on that infinitesimal displacement acted by vector force F. Yan. So ang ating work doon is the scalar product of the vector F and the displacement DL. Okay. And the definition of the scalar product is here. Okay. So F cosine P DL. So magnitude of the vector F that is along with the direction of the vector DL. Okay, kaya nag-cosine P tayo. Okay? So scalar product lang po 'yan or the dot product of the vector F and DL. So para makuha yung work or yung maliit na work dun sa infinitesimal displacement na 'yon. So ngayon, para makuha natin yung total work from point 1 to point 2, we have to integrate the infinitesimal displacement from point 1 to point 2. Ano? So ganito 'yon. So yung ating force is 'yan. Okay? Yung force is with angle P with respect to this infinitesimal displacement DL, okay? So yung makaka-apik lang sa ating work again is the parallel force or the parallel for or the force component which is in the direction of the vector DL, okay? So ito yung F parallel diyan is ito, okay? Symbol for the component of the force that is parallel to the another vector is ganyan. Yung namang perpendicular ay nakaganto. Ayan o. Yan. So, yung F perpendicular dyan, walang epekto yan dun sa ating work. Okay? Tandaan. Kahit pa dito sa part na ito, dito sa part na yan, kahit sa part dyan, walang epekto yung ating F perpendicular doon sa ating work. The only force that can affect the work is only the parallel component forces with respect to the infinitesimal displacement DL. Okay? So ito lang. Yan lang. Kaya ito lang yung nasa formula. Hindi naman F sine P, di ba? Okay. Yan. So yan. Only the component, so again, only the component of vector F parallel to the displacement, so yan yon, F cosine P, contributes to the work done by vector F. Okay, so anong kahalagahan naman ni F perpendicular niya? So, ang naapektahan lang niya is the direction of motion. Okay, so dito lang siya sa P nakakaapekto. Okay, yung F perpendicular. Okay. So, yan. And para makuha natin yung total work within this path, curve path, so, kumuha tayo ng isang maliit na DL, infinitesimal displacement, di ba? And then, inanalyze natin kung anong force yung mag-a-act doon. So, and we arrived that the D work is equals to F cosine P DL or the dot product of the vector F and the vector displacement DL. Okay? And para makuha natin yan, so maliit pa lang yan, para makuha na yan, we have to integrate the D work from point 1 to point 2. Okay? So ito yung magiging equation niya. Work or capital letter W is equals to the integration of F cosine P DL from point 1 to point 2. Okay? Or integration of F parallel, so sin vector F yan, ano, F parallel to the DL. Okay? So F parallel to the DL, so integration. Same lang din yan. So F parallel to the force is equals to F cosine P. Okay? Or integration of the dot product of the vector F and vector DL. So yun. Ito, tandaan nyo, napakahalaga nito, yan. So, ito yung pinakamadali eh, na ginagamitin natin. Kapag kumukuha ng work, when we are dealing with work and energy for motion along a curve, ano? Ayan. So, example tayo, motion on a curve path. So, at a family picnic, you are appointed to push your obnoxious cousin Throckmorton in swing figure 6.24. So, yan. So, meron tayong duyan, ano yung duyan, and merong chain which is rigid. So, when we say rigid, ay hindi siya nababatak and hindi siya nako-compress. Okay? And yan, negligible yung weight niya, sabihin dyan, ano. His weight is W. So, yung weight nung batang ito is always directly downward to the ground, ano. So, yun yung weight natin, small letter W. Then, the length of the chain is R. Length ng chain is R. So, ito, from rest siya. Andito yung duyan, imagine nyo. And then, itutulak. Kasi, in a point siya eh, na itulak niya yung kasin niya, no? With the varying force, horizontal force, vector F, ano? So, yan yun, no? So, so, tracky until the chains make an angle theta sub O. So, ba, papaliwanag ko mamaya kung bakit naging theta sub O yan. Okay. To do this, you exert a varying horizontal vector F. So, horizontal vector F. So, pamula dito sa part na at rest, so nagbabari. So, kaunting pwersa lang. At sa part na to, kaunting pwersa lang. Ito lang yon. Yan lang yon. And sa part na to, nandito na yung ating duyan. So, ito lang yon. Ito na yung force, madadagdagan. And sa part na ito, hanggang doon na, hanggang dito na. Okay. So, hanggang doon na. So, paghaba ng length ng ating magnitude ay paglakas, ano. So nagbabago yung ating i-apply na force nung ano, nung bata, no. Then that starts at zero and gradually increases just enough that trachea and the swing move very slowly. So mabagal lang yung move nung ating trachea, ano, nung duyan. And remain very nearly equilibrium throughout the process. So, throughout the process, very nearly equilibrium, meaning noon ay yung motion ng duyan pamula dito at rest hanggang doon at angle P ay very nearly in equilibrium. What does it mean? Ibig sabihin yung velocity natin dito nung paggalaw ng duyan, yung angular velocity is constant. Okay? And the acceleration is zero. Okay? And kapag ang acceleration ng zero, zero yung ating net force doon. Okay? Tandaan yon, kasi gagamitin natin yon mamaya. Okay? Tanong, what is the total work done on a trachy by all forces? So, when we say total work done, yan na yung lahat ng work na nagawa ng lahat ng forces. Okay? So, ang forces lang naman dito is yung nasa chain, yung bigat ng ating ng bata, and also yung varying force. Ano? Varying force. Yung chain natin ay hindi nababata. Meaning, magko-contribute ng motion along a curve path which on a part of a circle. Ano? Kasi constant yung radius natin eh. Constant yung chain. So, magkocontribute niyang part of a circle path. Okay? Yan. So, ang tanong doon, what is the total work on a trachy by all forces? So, net force. Kailangan natin ng net force dyan. Ay sinabi na very nearly in equilibrium. That's why, kapag kinuha natin yung net force niyan ay zero. Ano? So, next, what is the work done by the tension T in chains? So, ano daw yung work done by tension T na yan? In the chains? Okay, tinatanong. Then, the last question is, what is the work you do by exerting the force vector F? So, by exerting this vector F, ano daw yung work na nagawa natin? na nagawa natin, okay? Then may note dito, neglect the weight of the chains and seat. So neglected na yung ating weight ng chain and also ng seat, ano, ng upuan. Okay? So free body diagram natin. So yan, free body diagram at this point, at point wherein the angle of the chain have an angle theta. Yung theta na yan, theta sub 0. Okay, theta sub 0, theta sub O, o theta sub 0, meaning nilagyan ng subscript na 0 para bigyan ng emphasis lang yung equilibrium, ano. So, ibig sabihin, pamula dun sa path na ito, dito at rest hanggang dun is equilibrium yung ating motion. Ano, equilibrium yung ating system kasi constant yung velocity niya, ano. So, very nearly equilibrium. So, nakalagay throughout the process. Okay, kaya theta sub O yan. So, yun lang yung ibig sabihin nun. Okay? Yan. What is yan? Okay, ito yung free body diagram yan. So, treat natin na particle siya. Yun, particle yan. Particle. So, mag-a-act dyan is the chain. Force of the chain. So, yan yung tension T. So, matetension yan. Ano? And ano pa yung weight natin. So yung weight ng bata ng nakasakay, no. So which is directly downward ang direction niya. And yung inapply nating force F, vector F. So nagbabago yan, okay? Nagbabago yan as the angle P changes, angle theta changes, okay? So yung angle nito galing daw no alternating angle from geometry lang, ano, alternating angle. So ito yon, yan. And yung t cosine theta na yan, t sine theta na yan ay the vertical and the horizontal component lang nung ating tension t. Okay, so yan ang first question is find the total work done by all forces. So may dalawang process tayong pwedeng gawin doon, ano. So una ay diniscuss natin last time, ano, hindi pala last time or previous topic kung paano kunin yung total work done within the system, ano. So unang way is kunin natin isa-isa yung work na nagawa by an specific work. So halimbawa ito yung tension T, kukunin natin yung work done by tension T on the object, ano. So yung tension T lang yung ko-consider natin na force doon, ano, na mag-a-act doon sa ating particle. And then isolate ulit yung vector, yung force F naman, work done by force F on the particle. Okay, and also ito work done by a weight, okay, on the particle, okay, as the position of the object changes, okay. So kapag nakuha natin yung tatlong work na yon, work due to tension, work due to F, and work due to weight, is pag-a-add-addin lang natin lahat and then makukuha na natin yung total work, okay. And the another way to find the total work done by all forces is to find the total net force or the effect of all the forces on the particle. And then tsaka natin i-multiply dun sa displacement. Okay? And by inspection dun sa ating problem ay sinabi na very nearly in equilibrium throughout the process. So meaning to say we can assume that the motion of the body is in equilibrium, or the net force on that motion is what? Equal to zero. So meaning kung zero yung ating force or net force doon sa lahat, yung effect ng tension T, yung F, and yung weight ay yung vector sum nila or the net force nila is zero. Meaning, kung walang force na imumultiply dun sa displacement natin from here to here, ay zero yung ating total work. So, i-define natin yan mamaya. Compute natin isa-isa kung tatama yung ating sagot. Okay? So, for now, by inspection only, so the total work here is equal to zero because the net force or the vector sum of all the forces acting on the body is equal to zero because stated sa problem, very nearly in equilibrium throughout the process. Okay, the second law or the first law of motion. Okay, ni Isaac Newton ha. Yan. Then the next question is to find the work done by the chain tension T. So yun. Ano daw yung work done by the tension T on the chain or on the truck Morton, okay? So kung makikita nyo yung tension T, yun yung ating force on the chain dun sa kadena. Okay? And kahit sa ang part dito, yung chain natin is constant. Okay, constant, tama? And yung tension T na yan, yung chain na yan, is kung kukuha tayo ng maliit na strip yan, strip dito, DL yan, kahit saang part dito, dito, or kahit saan dyan, ay we will notice that the tension T or the chain is always perpendicular to the infinitesimal displacement DL. Okay? So, kung nai-imagine nyo. And kung perpendicular yung ating tension T always doon sa ating displacement, infinitesimal displacement DL na yan, ay kung kukunin natin yung work, ay diba, ang ating work is the scalar product or the dot product of the two vector quantities, okay? And the dot product of two vector quantities is the defined as the T cosine of the angle between DL, okay? And the cosine of 90, kasi perpendicular lahat, cosine of 90 is what? Cosine of 90 is, kung pipindutin nyo sa kalko yan, 0. 0 ang magiging sagot nyan. Meaning, yung work dito, work done by the chain tension T. So, work done by tension T only yan ha, hindi lahat. Okay? Is also 0. Kasi cosine of 90 ay 0. Okay? So, we can conclude by inspection only that the work due to tension T, chain T, is equal to zero. Kasi yung angle between the two vector, the tension T, and the infinitesimal displacement DL is always 90 degree. Okay? Yan. So, motion and curved part. So, compute the work done. So, last question is to compute the work done by F. So, kanina, work done by T. So, ngayon, work done by F. Yung varying force na in-apply natin ng bata. Okay? Natin. Doon sa truck Morton. So, ano yung work done by F na yan? Okay? Yan. So, to compute, so, yung work natin is the integral of the dot product of vector F and the infinitesimal displacement DL. So, napaliwanag na yan kanina. So, kuha tayo ng maliit na strip dito na infinitesimal displacement DL, which is also equal dito. So, yan yon. Yan yung DL na yan. Okay, infinitesimal displacement DL. And also, yan yung ating, sa geometry, yan yung ating DS. Okay, DS. Kaya, magiging equal yan sa integral of F cosine theta DS. Okay, DS, kaya naging DS to. So yung F cosine theta naman ay siyempre dot product tayo, so dapat ay yan yung formula ng dot product, eh, F cosine theta times the another, the magnitude of the another vector, ano. So yan yon. So next, so yan. So yung DL natin, ito yon. Kung kukuha tayo ng maliit na line dito, na displacement diyan, infinity sa mag-displacement DL, and also equal yan sa DS. Okay? And DS is in terms of theta, kukunin natin. So yung angle dito, angle doon, pamula doon. Ayan, hanggang doon. So yung angle dyan, bounded by that arc, is the d theta. D theta. Okay? D theta yan. And by geometry, so yung length ng ds na ito is equal to radius r times the d theta. Okay? Kaya nagkaroon dito nito. Okay, yan. So kasi ang target natin is to make the variable or the make the forces and the DL, or the vector F and the vector DL, in terms of theta, kasi yun yung nagbabago, yun yung nagbabari dito. So vector F varies as the angle theta changes. Okay, so dapat in terms of d theta, dapat d, yung ds na yan is d theta, and yung ating forces is also in terms of theta. Then i-integrate natin siya from the lower limit theta sub 1 to theta sub 0. Okay, so from theta here, so 0 pa yan, and then hanggang doon. Okay, so na may ilet na natin yung ds natin in terms of theta, which is ito. So yung f naman, so paano natin gagawin nating in terms of theta yung ating f, yung magnitude f natin. Okay, so using an equilibrium equation, equilibrium condition, so sinabi kanina very nearly equilibrium yung ating process, ano, yung motion. So yung net force therefore is equal to 0. So walang net force dyan. So 0 yung ating net force. So kaya in-equate sa 0 yung summation of F sub X, assuming rightward positive, is equal to 0. And also yung summation of F sub Y, assuming upward positive, is also equal to 0. Kasi yung net force nga natin kapag equilibrium ay 0. Okay? So then, summation of F sub X, kung titingin tayo dito saan? Saan tayo titingin? Dito sa free body diagram. So, yung free body diagram natin na yan. So, F sub X is, summation of F sub X is equal to 0. So, lahat ng force na may X component yan, isa sum up natin. Considering the direction, so positive to the right and negative to the left. Okay, banata natin. So, unahin natin, summation of F sub X is equal to, so, ano ba yung may horizontal component dyan? Horizontal forces component dyan? Si vector F, si force F ba? Si tension T, si W? So, si force F is in line with the direction of the x-axis, meaning horizontal, ano lang siya. Okay? Horizontal component lang siya. Okay? So, meaning yung F natin is positive F. Okay? And then, ano pa yung may horizontal component dyan? Dito tayo nakatingin pa. F sub X pa lang tayo, ha? Okay? So, F. And, yung may horizontal component pa dyan na makaka-affect dun sa ating system is yung tension T. Okay? Tension T. So, alin dyan? Siyempre, yung ating T sine theta. T sine theta, which is in opposite to the direction that we assumed. So, that's why negative T sine theta yan. Okay? So, in-assume natin na rightward positive. Okay? Then equate natin sa 0. And that would be the first equation. And the next is summation of f sub y. So alin ba yung may vertical component or forces dyan na makaka-affect dun sa ating object or particle with respect to the vertical axis. So yung ating si force F, so wala na yan, horizontal na yan. Ito si W, yung ating weight, yung weight nung bata, which is directly downward. So negative W yan. And ano pa? Negative dahil pababa siya dun sa ating assume. And then yung tension T, which is the vertical component of tension T, is T cosine theta. So positive siya. T cosine theta positive. And then sum up or vector sum nun is equal to 0, kasi we conclude that the system is in equilibrium situation. Okay, and target natin itong F na ito ay magawin na in terms of theta. So from this condition, so kunin natin yung value ng F in terms of theta. Okay, so paano yun? I-eliminate natin yung tension T dun sa equation. So paano? Direct substitution ng equation 2 to equation 1. So transpose lang algebra. So find the value of T here in terms of W and theta, and then substitute dun sa value ng T doon, and then find the force F in terms of theta and W. And yung makukuha nating sagot doon, so algebra lang naman po 'yon, ano? Napakadali lang noon. And yung ating force F from this situation is equal to W tangent theta. Okay, W tangent theta. Yan, so gagamit lang tayo ng mga identities diyan para makuha 'yan, no? And then sine over cosine is equals to tangent theta, kasi yun yung magiging labas dito, ano? Sine over cosine theta multiplied by W, yun yung ating vector F. And sine over cosine is equal to tangent theta. Okay, yan. So nakuha na natin yung force F in terms of theta, and also yung ds in terms of theta din. So substitution lang yan. So W tangent theta and cosine P, substitution lang itong equation na to, ha? Yan. Yung F natin, ayun yun. W tangent theta and then cosine, ayun yun. Cosine theta. And yung ds, which is equal to dl and equal to rd theta, ayun yun. Okay? So evaluate the integral. Evaluate natin. So yung weight natin is constant together with the radius. Radius natin constant. Ilalabas natin ang integral sign yan. So ang matitira na lang is yung ating sine theta d theta. Bakit nagkaganon? Kasi itong tangent theta is sine over cosine. Sine over cosine. And kung i-multiply natin sa cosine yan, cancel out yung cosine. Matitira na lang ay yung sine. Okay? So kaya naging ganyan yung sine theta, yung ating equation ng work, ano? So work is equals to weight times radius integral of sine of theta d theta. Ano yung limit natin? Kasi yung theta natin, yung ating d dito ay in terms of theta na, so dapat yung limit ay angle, ano? So from 0, yung angle dito from 0 to theta sub o. Okay? Yan. And then the integral of sine is what? Kasi ang derivative ng sine is cosine, and derivative of cosine is negative sine. So therefore, the integral of negative sine is negative cosine. Tama? So negative cosine. And magiging ganito yung ating work done by force F ano, work done by force F. Okay, yan. So WR times the quantity of 1 minus cosine theta sub O, kasi cosine nga eh, negative cosine ano. So kung sasubstitute natin yung tet upper limit at saka lower limit, magiging ganito yung sagot. Okay, so yun yung work done by the force F. Okay, so patunayan natin na yung ating inspection natin kanina is tama. Okay, so paano yun? So gagamitin natin yung dot product, integral of the dot product of two vector quantity, para makuha natin yung work done by each forces. Okay, so yan. So kailangan natin ng vector, ano? Vector. So yung DL natin is in vector form, magiging ganito. Vector form. So yung I is the vector along with the x-axis, and yung J is the vector along with the y-axis. Okay? So 2D lang tayo, hindi naman tayo 3D. That's why IJ lang ang meron tayo. Okay? IJ ang meron tayo. So 2D lang tayo. Okay? Ayan. And also, dapat yung ating forces is in vector form, unit vector form. So, yan. Unahin natin si vector T. So, from the diagram, pre-body diagram, yung I, yung X component ni tension T is what? Ito. T sine theta, which is opposite to the direction assumed as positive rightward. Ano? So, negative T sine theta yung ating x component ni vector T dyan. And the y component of the vector T is ito yung T cosine theta, which is positive. Okay? Upward siya. Tama? So, another na kailangan nating i-transform into vector form is the weight. So, yung weight natin dyan is only directly downward. Directly downward. So, meaning, ay J lang yan. So, Y component lang yung meron dyan. So, which is negative WJ. Oh, meron din, lalo kung gusto nyo ilagay yung I hat, ay di, may X component naman siya na 0. So, nothing important. Ano, cancel out lang din. So, matitira lang dyan is ito lang din. Okay? And, next is the vector F. So, in terms, i-transform natin into unit vector. So, yung vector F dyan is, kung nakikita nyo sa pre-body diagram, is along only in the direction of the x-axis, positive rightward. So, kung nakikita nyo, yan yun, no? So, I hat multiplied by the magnitude of F. So, positive siya. Ano po? So, yan. Nakuha na natin ang vector form ng mga forces and also yung ating infinitesimal displacement, DL. So, kunin na natin yung work using the definition na na-derive natin kanina, which is yan. So, that product of the vector T and the infinitesimal displacement DL. So, kung natatandaan nyo, yung that product ay, so, ba? That product of vector A dot B, yan, is equal to what? AX. So, X component of the vector A multiplied by X component of the vector B plus the AY, Y component of the vector A multiplied by the Y component of the vector B. Kung 3D tayo, so magkakaroon tayo ng Z component. So A sub Z plus A sub Z multiplied by B sub Z. Okay? So, ito yung dot product natin or the scalar product. So, apply natin dito. Yan. So, the x component of the vector t is what? Ayun, no? Negative t sine theta. And the x component of the infinitesimal displacement dl is what? Ayan, d cosine theta. D cosine theta. Okay? Ayan. So, kaya nagkaganan yan. Okay? Plus, the y component of the tension T. So, ito yun. Kaya nagkaroon dito. Ayan. And the y component of the dl, infinitesimal displacement is ds sine theta. So, kaya nagkaroon yan. Okay? So, susunod lang tayo dun sa rules, ano, dun sa formula ng scalar product. Eh, kasi itong scalar product nito, equal na yan dun sa ating work done by T, tension T, no? And, kung i-add natin ito, equal to zero. Okay? So, tama yung ating assume kanina, yung ating inspection kanina, na yung tension T contributes a zero work to the truck Morton. Ano? So, tama, ano? Kasi nga, perpendicular dito, ano? So, nung ginamit natin yung definition ng ating work, ay tama yung ating sagot, which is also zero. Okay? And ano pa? Yung work done by weight W. So, that product lang nung vector W and infinitesimal displacement DL. Okay? So, yung W natin is only vertical component lang. Vertical, on the vertical axis lang. So, negative W. And yung DL, yung Y component ni DL is what? Ito, DS sine theta. Okay? Then, yung ating dot product ni W and DL ay ito. So, negative W sine theta DS. So, mamaya, i-evaluate natin yan. So, check muna natin kung tama yung ating inspection kanina. Okay? So, yeah. Next is the F, the work done by F to the truck Morton is yan. The dot product of vector F and the infinitesimal displacement DL. Okay, yan. Is equal to F D cosine. So, yung ating x-component lang naman siya, so F lang. So, ang x-component ni DL is what? Ito, DS cosine theta. Ayan, yun na. So, evaluate lang. So, magiging F cosine theta DS. So, just like as we get a while ago dun sa kanina, no? So, F cosine theta. So, tama ito. Tama yung kanina natin. So, F cosine theta DS. Okay? Na nakuha nga natin yan, yung kanina, yung WR times the quantity of 1 minus cosine theta. So, yan yon. So, ngayon, paano natin ma-check kung tama yung ating W total work is equal to 0. So, kunin natin yung value, yung lahat ng work done by T, work done by W, work done by vector F. So, ito, makuha na eh. Zero na eh. So, ito, nakuha na din. Which is equals to WR, yung weight times the radius times the quantity of 1 minus cosine theta. So, hindi na lang natin nakukuha is ito. Yung work due to weight. And then, pag nakuha natin yan, isum up natin, dapat ang magiging sagot is W total or the total work done by the all forces on the body is equal to 0. Okay? So, kuhanin natin ito. Ayan. Kuhanin natin. So, work done by the weight is equals to the integral of the dot product of vector W and the infinitesimal displacement DL. Ayan. So, by the definition, so ito lang yon, ito yon. So, integrate lang natin. integrate lang. So, negative W sin theta, R d theta. So, kasi yung ds natin is R d theta yan. Integrate natin, labas natin yung negative, yung constant, which is W and yung ating radius. So, labas natin ang integral sign. So, negative WR. And then, integrate natin yung sin theta d theta from angle 0 to angle theta O. Okay? So, integral ng sin is ganun din yung kanina, no, negative cosine. And then, substitute natin yung upper limit minus yung lower limit. So, ganyan yung magiging sagot. Negative WR times the quantity of 1 minus cosine theta sub O. So, yung kanina ay same na same lang dito. Ano? Kaya lang, positive yung dito. Positive. Okay? Positive. So, ito yung work done by work by weight. And the work done by vector F is same as the magnitude here. Kaya lang, positive sign siya. Okay? And kung i-add up natin lahat or kukunin natin yung vector sum ng lahat ng or the work, yung sum ng lahat ng work done by each forces ay makukuha natin kasi ito zero na, cancel, wala. So ang i-add na lang natin is work done by W and work done by vector F. Kung ito ay same and magnitude yung dalawa but different yung sign, so negative yung isa, positive naman yung isa, so magiging sagot diyan kung ipa-plus natin yung negative at saka yung negative WR times the quantity of 1 minus cosine theta sub O plus WR times the quantity of 1 minus cosine theta sub O, ayan ang magiging sagot, 0, di ba? So, tama yung ating sagot. Okay? Zero. Zero. The work done by the total, by the all forces is zero. So, tama yung ating inspection. Okay? So, mahalaga yung kaya nating mag-inspect muna bago tayo mag-sagot ng problem para ma-minimize natin yung time. Kasi sa board exam, ano ba? Sa board exam, hindi naman kailangan ng solution doon. So, kailangan doon ay ma-point out or masagutan natin yung tamang sagot. Ano, as fast as we can, dapat ay ma-prove natin na tama yung sagot natin. Ano? So, yan. Okay? So, kung tama yung inspection natin, so, tama yung sagot natin. Hindi na natin kailangan ito. So, kakain pa ito ng madaming oras. Ano? Ang bawa sa board exam. Ano po? Yan. Pero sa atin, sa subject pa natin ngayon, since we are in the process of learning, ay kailangan natin siyempre ng solutions. Ano? Yan. So, jump up niya tayo dun sa power. So, tapos na tayo sa work energy. So, power tayo. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng power? Power is the rate at which work is done. So, gaano ba katagal yung trabaho, yung work? No? So, this time, i-relate natin yung quantity na time. Yung time. Okay? So, power is yan. So, halimbawa, meron tayong tinarbaho. Nilift natin yung box from time to 0 and to time is equals to 5 seconds. So, 5 seconds yung duration. And we apply a work equal to 100 joules. So, yung power natin is kung ang power is the rate of time at which the work done is ganito yung ating formula for the power. Diba? So, work over change in time. Okay? Work done over delta T. Okay? So, 100 joule over 5 second is 20 watts. So, yung ating joule per second na unit is equal to 1 watt. Ha? Yan. So, on the other hand, What you do on the same box to lift it the same distance in 1 second naman. So this time 1 second naman, dito 5 seconds. So ano yung pagkakaiba ng power nila? So 100 joules over 1 second is 100 watts. So mas mataas yung power nung paglift natin ng mas mabilis. Mas mabilis ano? So pagbilis, paglaki ng power siyempre. Pagbagal, paghina no power. Okay, power is defined as the P average is equals to delta work over delta time. Or the rate of change of work per time interval ano. So average power yan from point 1 to point 2. So yung work at point 1 and work at point 2, kukunin yung difference, so delta W. And yung delta T, yung time duration on. Okay? And sometimes yung ating rate is not constant. So kailangan natin ng mag-derivative, ano? Sometimes the rate is not constant. So kung ang graph ng ating kung kukunin natin yung work over time graph, so ito itong average na constant yung slope, so meaning constant yung average peak power, constant yung power dyan. So paano naman kung hindi constant ano, so yung graph ay ganyan. So ito yung time, ito yung work, so pag ganyan yung ating graph. So kailangan natin kunin yung instantaneous power. So instantaneous power, it is the limit of the average power as the time interval delta T approaches zero. Okay, so meaning the slope at the WT graph is equal to the instantaneous power. Okay, yung slope dito is equals to the instantaneous power. Okay, so kailangan natin ng slope nung graph na to. So dW with respect to time. So so may example, may mga problem tayo na yung work is varying with time. So given dapat yon ano, work is varying with time. Yung equation of a line ay i-derivative natin yon to find the slope, and the slope of the graph in the WT graph is equal to the instantaneous power. Okay? So, pag-usapan natin yung mga units. So, the SI unit for power is watt after the late English inventor James Watt yan, ha. So, yung watt ay ang symbol niya is capital W. And 1 watt is equals to 1 joule per second. 1 joule per second. So horsepower, 1 horsepower is equals to 746 watts or 0.746 kilowatts. And 1 horsepower is equals to 550 foot pound per second or equal to 33,000 foot pound per minute. And 1 kilowatt hour is equals to 10 raised to 3 joule per second times 3,600 equal to 3.6 times 10 raised to 6 joules or 3.6 megajoules. So, ito ba? Power pa ba ito? 1 kilowatt hour. So, yan ay hindi power. Ha? Ito power to. Ito power to. Yung watts power, horsepower, yung horsepower natin is also a power. Foot pound per minute is power. Foot pound per second is power. Itong kilowatt hour, power ba siya? So, work or energy itong kilowatt hour. Ano po? Kasi kung titingnan nyo dito, cancel out itong hour dyan. Matitira na lang ay joule. And yung joule natin is a unit for work or energy. So work or energy, yan ang kilowatt hour. Hindi siya power, ha? Yan. Okay. So P average is equals to delta W over delta T. Average power yan. From point 1 to point 2. Okay. So we can express the power in terms of force and velocity. So yan. So itong delta W na yan, equal yan dito, di ba? So parallel to the delta S. So yung i-multiply natin yan, yun yung work, ano, delta W over delta T. And itong term na ito, yan yung average velocity. So therefore, ang ating P average is also equal to the product of the force parallel to the velocity. Okay? Yan. Or the dot product, kung naka vector form, so power is also like a work equal to the scalar product of two vector quantities siya, no? So the scalar product of F, force F, and the vector product and the velocity vector, ano? So yan. So that would be equal to the instantaneous rate at which the force vector F does work on a particle. Okay, tandaan yan. Mahalaga yan. Okay. Mahalaga po yan. So P power is equals to instantaneous power is equals to the dot product of the vector F and the velocity vector. Okay. So example tayo, force and power. So each of the four jets engines, an Airbus A380 airliner develops a thrust. So when we say thrust, ito yung force forward or the forward force on the airliner. Okay? Forward force on the airliner of 322,000 Newton or 72,000 pounds. Okay? Yan. So, jet yan. So, yung jet engines natin yan. So, forward force daw niya is 322,000 Newton. So, when the airplane is flying at 250 meter per second, so lumilipad siya at a velocity of 250 meter per second or 900 kilometer per hour or roughly 560 miles per hour. Tanong, what horsepower does each engine develop? So, yan yung airplane natin. So, yung apat yan. Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat. And that there is a forward force on the airliner. 322, dito yon. Yan. Forward force. The airliner. Okay? When the airplane is flying at 250 meter per second, so constant yung velocity niya, 250 meter per second, so tanong, what horsepower does its engine develop? Okay? So gamitin natin yung definition ng power in terms of velocity. Okay? So P is equals to F parallel multiplied by velocity. Napakadali lang. Given na given yan. So yung F parallel, bakit ito na mismo? Kasi forward force, meaning in line with the direction of motion siya. Thrust. So meaning yun ang 322. Wala nang kailangan pa ng sine and cosine. Okay? 322,000 Newton. Or 3.22 times 10 raised to 5 Newton multiplied to our velocity, which is 250 meter per second. Okay, evaluate. So 8.05 times 10 raised to 7 Newton meter per second yung sagot. And Newton meter per second is equals to joule per second. And 1 joule per second is equal to 1 watt. That's why ito ang ating unit. 8.05 times 10 raised to 7 watts. Okay? Ang tanong is what horsepower? So we have to convert this into horsepower. And 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watts. So we need to divide it by 746 watts. Yan. Matitira na lang ay horsepower. Tama? Yan. Calculate. Magiging sagot is 108,000 horsepower. Napakadali lang. Ano po? Simpleng-simple. So, another example is a power climb. A 50.0 kilogram marathon runner runs up the stairs to the top of the Chicago's 443 meter tall Willis Tower. So, yan siya. Aakyatin daw niya. The tallest building in the United States to leap herself to the top of in 15 minutes. So, 15 minutes lang yung kailangan para makapunta dun sa top. Okay? Noong 443 meter tall na Willis Tower. Ang bigat niya is 50 kilogram. What must be her average power output? Express your answer in watts, in kilowatts, and in horsepower. So, yan. So, the first thing to do here is alamin muna natin yung work na kailangan para makaakyat siya vertically, ano, in 15 minutes. Okay? Yan. So, yung ating work na kailangan para makaakyat siya is yung MGH or work, diba, force times distance. Force times displacement. Yung force natin dyan, due to weight, yan, is MG. MG yan. Mass times acceleration due to gravity. And yung displacement is ito, yan. Which is 443 meter tall. So, yan yung work na kailangan natin para makaakyat yung 50 kilogram marathon runner. Ano? So, kailangan yung kasi MG. So, dapat ito kasi kung pababa, negative yan eh. Negative. Kaya lang ay para makataas, kailangan nating i-oppose yun ng ganung amount din. Tama? So, negative MG. Yan yung pababa. Kasi yung direction ng displacement is papunta doon. Yung direction naman due to weight, force due to weight is pababa. So, negative dapat, di ba? Pero kung i-analyze natin, ang tanong is to leap herself to the top in 15.0 meters minutes. So, yung magnitude nun, ang kailangan natin, pababa, kailangan natin i-oppose. So, this time, equate natin yun. Ano? So the work done by the work needs is equal to MGH. Okay? MGH. Ayan. So yung mass natin is 50.0 kilogram times 9.8 meter per second square. So acceleration due to gravity, constant yan. So Earth, ano? And yung displacement is 443 meters. Ayan. So, work pa lang yan. 2.17 times 10 raised to 5 joules yung kailangan nating work para makaakyat. Okay? So, bakit 443 meters na? Kasi yung work natin, yung weight is vertical. So, dapat vertical din yung displacement. Okay? So, ang tanong is power eh. Power output. So, nakuha na natin yung work. So, divide natin dun sa time. Okay? Which is 15.0 minutes. So, ito yung kailangan natin. So, joule per second, dapat i-convert natin yung minutes into seconds. So, 15 times 60 is equals to 900 seconds because there is 60 seconds in 1 minute. 1 minute. Okay? So, divide natin yung 2.17 times 10 raised to 5 joules sa 900 seconds. And equal yan saan? Sa 241 watts. Okay? And In kilowatts, 0.241 kilowatt. Bakit? Dahil there is 1,000 watts in 1 kilowatt. Tama. So, we have to divide it into 1,000 watts. So, magiging sagot is 0.241 kilowatts. And kung ko-convert natin pa ulit, kasi tanong dito, express your answer in watts, in kilowatts, and in horsepower. So, in watts, 241 watts yung sagot. In kilowatts naman, 0.241 kilowatts. So, para ma-convert sa horsepower, so, there is a 746 watts in 1 horsepower. So, kailangan nating i-multiply siya sa 1 over 746 watts. Okay? Yan. So, ito magiging sagot. 0.323 HP. Okay. So, another solution is paganito. P average equals to force parallel multiplied by the average velocity. So, yung force parallel dun sa displacement. Ito yung displacement natin. Yung force parallel dyan is yung ating weight. Ano? So, yun yung kailangan natin i-oppose. Ano? So, absolute value na lang. Ano? So, yan. So, weight is equals to mg. And then, yung velocity, average velocity is, paano natin makukuha? So, yan. So, average velocity is 0.492 meter per second. So, saan nakuha yon? Saan nakuha? So, distance over, hindi yung ano, distance, yung 15 distance natin is 443 meters. I-divide natin ng 3,600. Ano? So, makukuha natin doon is 0.492 meter per second. Okay? Ito yon. Ito siya. So, ang magiging sagot dyan is also equal to the previous answer, 241 watts. Okay, same lang yung magiging answer niya kahit yung isang process yung gamitin natin. Okay, yan. So, activity tayo last time. Spring yung ating pinag-aralan. So, varying force activity. Try to solve this. So, 3 identical 6.40 kilogram masses are hung by 3 identical springs. So, pare-parehas yung spring na yan, yung type niyan, as shown in the figure. Each spring has a force constant. So, yun yung K, 7.8 kilonewton per meter and was 12.0 centimeter long before any masses were attached to it. So, yun yung characteristic or properties ng spring, you know. Yan. Then, so, your duty is to draw a free body diagram of its mass. Draw nyo daw. Then, how long is its spring when hanging as shown? So, how long is its spring when hanging as shown? Okay? So, gaano daw katagal? First, isolate only the bottom mass. So, nagbigay ng hint. Ano? Then, treat the bottom two masses as a system. Finally, treat all three masses as a system. Okay? Yan. So, next activity is a 20.0 kilogram crate sits at rest at the bottom of a 15.0 meter long ramp that is inclined at 34.0 degree above the horizontal. So, a constant horizontal force of 290 Newton is applied to the crate to push it up the ramp. Okay? While the crate is moving, the ramp exerts a constant frictional force on it that has a magnitude of 65 Newton. Tanong, what is the total work done on the crate during its motion from the bottom to the top of the ramp? Next question, how much time does it take the crate to travel to the top of the ramp? Okay. So yan. Yan yung ating dalawang activity. Okay, thank you. That concludes our topic for today. Thank you.